Hello, I'd like to talk about the micropulsing feature of the SOTA Silver Pulser unit. The Silver Pulser unit shown here is our latest model SP5. The Silver Pulser is powered by a 9-volt alkaline style battery. Please remember to use an alkaline battery and not heavy duty, as the heavy duty will not work properly. On the battery that comes with your unit, you may have a protective covering over the terminals. Please remember to peel that protective covering off in order to use the battery properly. And here's a battery with the protective covering removed. Keep in mind that you can also use a rechargeable style battery. The one shown here is a 9-volt rated nickel metal hydride. And please remember to check to make sure that the rechargeable battery that you're planning on purchasing does actually fit in the unit. You may need to go to the store with your unit, try the battery, make sure it fits. We have no control over the size of the batteries and they do vary, so please remember to do that to ensure the battery that you use will fit the unit. Okay, let's put the battery into the unit, and how that's done is we'll turn the unit over. We're going to slide off the battery compartment and just take a look inside here. You'll notice there's two metal prongs, and these are the prongs that make contact with the battery terminals. Please make sure that they're gently pulled forward so they make good contact, and I'll show you how to do that. Just get your finger inside the unit and just tug just gently on the battery terminal prongs, and that's as simple as that. Now, if you notice inside the unit, there are two plastic rings. There's a larger ring at the bottom with a negative terminal on it, and there's a smaller ring at the top. And if we look at the end of the battery terminals are a different size. There's a larger negative terminal and a smaller positive terminal. So what you do is you line up the larger negative terminal on the bottom with the larger plastic ring, and then you just simply slide the unit into place, click it in, and we're going to simply put the battery compartment lid back on, turn the unit over. I'll turn the unit on, and you should see a green on light. That shows us that with the battery is working fine, the unit's ready to go and fully powered. The next step now is the preparation of the micropulsing probe cord. On our model SP5 Silver Pulser, we use the latest generation conductive rubber probes. As you can see here, the probe ends are made of rubber. They certainly are conductive, and they can be pulled off the connector by giving a little tug. Just make sure that the metal connector itself is nice and clean, and if you need to, just use some soap and water to clean it. Replace the probe onto the connector and make sure you push it all the way into the end. The next step, which is really important, is I want to test the conductivity of the probe cord itself before I connect to the wrist. How I'm going to do that is we need to connect it to the Silver Pulser unit. On the end of the Silver Pulser unit, there's a 6-pin DIN jack. And not surprisingly, on the end of the probe cord, there's a 6-pin DIN plug with small little pins on the inside of the plug itself. It's really important that you line that up perfectly with the Silver Pulser unit. And on the top of the DIN plug, there's a small plastic indent. That tells you that's the top portion of the plug and that you would insert it into the unit exactly like that. You just gently find how it fits in and then push it into place. The next thing I need to do is touch the two probe ends together to make a connection. I'm going to turn the unit on, and I'm going to turn the intensity up to full. If there's electrical connection, the yellow light will flash, which it is doing right now. That tells me this probe cord is ready to go and working perfectly. I'll just turn the unit off. With the probe cords, it's very important that you never touch the probe cords, the rubber probe ends against your skin. We need to use the cotton sleeves. We have two cotton sleeves, one for each probe. There's three sewn edges and one opening on the end. There's cotton on one side and Velcro on the other. And if I just hold it and push it together here, you can see that it just opens up the opening between the Velcro and the cotton sleeve. You're going to take the probe cord end and slowly spin or twist it into the cotton sleeve, just like I'm doing now. Makes it go in nice and easy. I'll do this with the other cotton sleeve. Again, I'll just push it open. There's the opening. Take the rubber probe, push it in, and again, give it a little gentle twisting motion. Push it all the way into the end. The next step now is we need to moisten or put water on the probe cords themselves. They need to be electrically conductive. They need to conduct electricity from there to your wrist. And we need to put the water on the cotton sleeves. And we do that by getting your water bottle, which has either tap water or distilled water, or even if you have trouble feeling the pulses, you can just put a touch of salt to make the water slightly more conductive. And just get a dropper full. It's real easy. Get a dropper full. This one only picked up about half. And you just start to lay in the water into the cotton sleeves. There's one done. And we'll do the second one. And you may get a little bit of beading of water. Don't worry about that. You may do this a couple of times depending on how moist your cotton sleeves are already. And what I like to do is just sort of squish it around a bit to make sure the water is nicely even distributed between the two. And we can see now that they're nicely moistened. We don't want to have it overly moistened or sopping wet. And if you have too much water, you just squeeze it out. But you have it nice and moist, and they're ready to go to the next step. I'm now ready to place the micropulsing cords on my wrist. I take the armband that's supplied with the unit, and this is used to hold the silver pulse unit on my arm. Just for convenience sake. It can either be placed over the bicep area, you can place it over the forearm area, or if you want, you don't have to use the armband. Instead, you can purchase a longer probe cord and put the silver pulse unit in your pocket, whatever is more convenient. The armband has a Velcro side to it, and I'm just going to open that up, place it over my forearm, and tighten the Velcro down just so it's snug. You don't want it too tight. Just like that. The next thing is to take the wrist strap, which has the neoprene side on one side and more of a cloth side on the other. We start by putting the neoprene side outwards, and if you notice, there's the other Velcro portion that we're going to have the cotton sleeves attached to. That's going to be on the outside so we can place the cotton sleeves properly. And how we do that is we just simply place it on the outside of the wrist, and I'm just going to then connect it up with the Velcro again. As you can see, there's the Velcro section that I'm going to be connecting to the cotton sleeves. We have two pulse points. We have the main pulse point where we take the pulse with that your a nurse or a doctor would take a pulse. It just runs down by the thumb area. And the second pulse point is just about here, just in line with the little finger. That's a little bit harder to find, but just know that one sits over the thumb, and we use the Velcro side of the cotton sleeves, and we put it right over the pulse point. And pretty well the other side, it's sort of like the same distance, same distance over here. And that sets us up perfectly for the alignment. Now I'm going to undo the wrist strap and turn it around. So now the cotton sleeves are on the wrist strap. I'm going to put my wrist over them. Use the Velcro again on the wrist strap And as you can see now, it's perfectly placed. Take my unit, and I'm going to just turn it on. Oh, I feel the pulses. And as I turn up the intensity, you should see the yellow flashing light flash. I've turned it up pretty high. And I can feel the pulses. It's just turn it up to a point where it's comfortable. You don't need to turn it up too much. As long as you feel the pulses and as long as that light is flashing, everything's working perfectly. I'm just going to turn it down to a comfortable level. I'm going to take the unit and place it on my armband, click it into place, like so. Okay, after a while, you may find that the sensation of the pulses diminishes, and that might be caused by the drying out of the cotton sleeves. That's completely normal. The cotton sleeves will dry out after time. It's real easy. You just get your dropper bottle of water here, get a little bit in your dabber and just dab a bit here and a dab a bit there, and you'll feel the pulses. There we go, a little bit stronger now. It's really important to not overwet the cotton sleeves. What happens is if you get too much moisture, the electricity will jump across rather than go in, and you won't feel it. You'll keep turning the unit up and you'll wear your battery out and you won't feel anything. So it's really important to keep the area between the cotton sleeves nice and dry. Some people even remove the wristband and dry it out and dry the wrist and reapply it, and that works real well too. Also, when you're pulsing, you may find that the pulse suddenly stops. That could be caused by a low battery. The unit will take all the charge in the battery and it may suddenly stop. And at that point, just turn the unit over and there's a red battery indicator light. And if the low battery is identified, that light will come on and you just simply replace the battery. This is where rechargeables come in handy. Also, after a period of time, you may find a little bit of wrist irritation. To help alleviate that, we recommend that you change wrists, alternate the wrists day to day. So today I have it on my left wrist, tomorrow I'll move everything over to the right wrist. Another thing you can do is once you remove the probes from the wrist, you can use a bit of MSM cream or vitamin E cream. And that's basically it. It's real simple, it feels real nice, and we're doing real well here. So you'll find it simple to operate, and we wish you happy pulsing. There are a few of you who may have very sensitive skin when doing the micropulsing. When you apply the wrist probes on the wrist and turn the electricity up, you may get a little bit of skin irritation. What we find works really well to help reduce that effect is the use of conductive gel. Conductive gel can be bought at any medical supply store, drug store, and it's the same gel used on TENS pads. It's very easy to apply. It comes in a little tube. What you do, get the cotton sleeves, pre-moisten it with a bit of water, take the conductive gel and just dab a bit onto the cotton sleeves, and then take your fingers and work it in nicely. So you have a fair amount of conductive gel in the sleeves. Do that on both sleeves, reapply it to the wrists, and you may find that really helps. Another thing to do is think about alternating the wrists each day. So today I may do the left wrist, tomorrow I may do the right wrist. The next thing too is when you've finished your micropulsing session, take the wristband off, clean your wrists with maybe soap and water, just get all the oils off, and then use maybe a healing type of gel, a healing type of lotion like MSM or vitamin E cream or even aloe vera gel. And the other thing too is some of you are on the other side who are not very sensitive and cannot feel the pulses. What we need to do is increase the conductivity of the water. Very simple to do. Take your bottle of water, grab a pinch of salt. Celtic sea salt probably works best because it has a less amount of impurities. Put it in the water, swish it around, make sure that it dissolves nicely, and then use that to wet your cotton sleeves. And again, that will help increase the conductivity so you feel the pulses better. You also have a number of options to the coverings on the probe cords themselves. Rather than using the standard cotton that's supplied with it, you can use paper towel. You can use cotton fleece. There's the same material out of diapers. The reason for that is that it actually holds water better. Or you can purchase cotton sleeves that do not have any Velcro on them, just cotton on both sides. So let's start with the paper towel. It's very simple. You cut out a square from the paper towel, basically the same length and width as the probe cord. You need to pre-moisten this, or else it'll be very difficult to handle. So I'm going to add a little bit of water on this, and just get a little bit wet, just so you can easily handle it. And then what you're going to do, I got big fingers here, but I'm going to try and do it for you. You're going to put it on the probe cord like this and basically start rolling. And then you turn the end in a bit and continue rolling. And before you know it, you've got a nice rolled up paper towel on the cotton, or sorry, on the probe cords in place of the cotton sleeves. And that's ready to go. It's already pre-moistened. And you just do it for the other side, and you're good to go. So the next thing we're going to do, it even holds its shape, it's kind of neat. So the next one is the fleece material. I've got these pre-wetted, so they're already got a little bit of moisture on them. Again, you do the exact same thing. You're going to start rolling them up. I got big fingers, so a little tough for me. Fold in on the ends, continue rolling, and these are a little bit bigger, of course, because it uses the cotton. So what you need to do now is get a piece of cotton thread, like I've got here, and you just go around it in a spiral. As you can see, it's tightening it up real nice, and you just keep going around and around, and you can tie it off. My fingers are too big for that, but I'm just going to keep rolling it around. Look at that. It comes out real nice. And these will actually retain its shape. If I pull that off, you'll see that it actually retains its shape quite nicely. Again, when this dries out, it's already got the hole ready for the probe cord to be inserted in. It works real well. The next thing, of course, is to, if you don't want to have the Velcro, some people find it's easier to use the cotton without the Velcro. Again, this one is sewn on three sides, just like the one with Velcro. So you need to sort of pinch it open a bit and get that opening, and it's a double layer, so you've got layers two up here and two down there. Make sure that it's just equally distributed, and you just sort of take the probe cord and find the proper opening. Again, you sort of spiral twist it into place as I'm doing here. See that? Just spiral it in. I got big fingers, so it's hard for me to do this, and push it all the way to the end. And that's it, real simple. Again, you just properly wet it with your dropper bottle, just like you would do with the other one. It absorbs water quite nicely. And then we place it on the wrist. Okay, the next step then is to place our non-Velcro cotton sleeves or probe covers, like what we made with the paper towel, or we've rolled our own with the cotton. What we need to do is take our wrist strap, which has two sides to it. One has a neoprene side, and the other has more of a cloth side. Make sure you place the neoprene side against your wrist, like this. And I'll now secure the wrist strap with the Velcro. So I've got it properly in place. Then you take the probe covers that, again, this does not have the Velcro. So what you do, you need to slide it into place in the proper orientation. That one's right over the thumb artery on the wrist. And you take your second one and you just slide it up and get it properly orientated over the little finger artery. So you can see this is a little bit more difficult to make sure that it stays in place than using the Velcro, but some people do prefer this. And to keep the probes wet, you would just take your little dropper bottle and squirt some water in there. Again, making sure that you don't over wet between the probes. Some of you may be using our older style metallic probe cords. Shown here is one of our silver ones. This is made out of pure silver. We had other ones that were gold plated and other ones that were made out of copper. With usage, the silver may oxidize, just means it'll turn dark and it's not very conductive, so you may not feel the pulses. So it's important that you get rid of the oxidation. And here's a heavily oxidized silver probe, and look how it compares to a nice shiny new one. And in order to remove the oxide, just take your green scrubby and you sort of roll it over and you firmly start to pull sideways, just gently. As you can see, it's starting to bring the nice bright color of the metal back. And this will get you much better electrical conduction and you'll feel the pulses better. And do that periodically whenever you see the buildup of the silver oxide.